On the one hand, the definition of Taylor series that we have seen in this chapter is not so bad. What is it? You've got some derivatives and some factorials and some monomials all in a sum. On the other hand, it's not really clear why we're putting so much energy into this, or what it's going to be good for, or how we're going to compute these efficiently. That is what comes next.